Hey guys, welcome back to our repair guys. In today's video guys, we're going to diagnose a car that does not start. And we're going to show you what you need to do guys, how to start all that process. We purchased this car from a car auction and it did not start. We didn't know if it runs and drives. From the amount of damage, it's very, very minimum damage. Okay, you can see a cracked bumper here. I don't think it's anything mechanical. So stay with us guys and we're going to cover what to do if your car does not start. Please guys, subscribe. For every car and model that we get, we'll make almost 200 videos, so please subscribe, and if you need help with anything, drop a comment below. We'll do our best to make a video for your problem. So I'm inside the car now, check it out. It cranks, but it does not start. So, what do we do first, guys? Okay, the first thing is to be able to see, okay, if you're going to hear noise from the fuel pump. And how you do that, when you turn the key on without starting the car, okay, to second position, you're going to hear a buzz sound, okay, from underneath somewhere the rear seat or right in front of the rear tire, underneath right there. So that's what we'll be testing now. Okay, so listen now. Yep, we can definitely hear an audible buzz sound coming from right somewhere in front of the rear tires, which is where the fuel tank is located. So that's a fuel pump noise. This is great news, that it means your fuel pump is not out. Now, what do you need to consider, guys? You need to go ahead and open the fuse panel. We need to get the owner's manual and we need to check a few fuses after that to make sure that the fuses for the ignition coils, fuel pump, in our case fuel pump works, but sometimes the fuel pump fuse and fuel injectors fuse will be different. And also the PCM ECU, which is the engine computer fuses. So that's what we'll be testing now. So if you open your manual, usually doesn't matter what vehicle it is, you need to go to the section that states fuses. Okay, in our case it's page 243 244, so I'll go ahead, open there. Okay, and the first thing that you can read is if you have a fuel pump shut off switch. In our case the switch is good, but if that switch is activated your car will not start. And all we have to do, find where it's located, press it down, and you have instructions as well. Check this thing out. Second, you need to go to the engine fuse compartment. Okay, and we're going to see what we need now out of here. In our case, okay, let me go ahead and show you now. Starter is fine because the car is cranking, so we don't need anything about starter. Fuel pump relay, in our case it's 26, however our relay is fine because you can hear the pump. Fuel pump diode, okay, this one as well, check it out. PCM, this is very important as well. This is another one, okay, it might state ECU, so check those fuses. There is more PCM, and usually you might see ignition coil fuse, but in our case it's under PCM, so it will not be there. Now, let's go ahead and just test one of the fuses, okay, like... Okay, right here, fuel pump fuse 68, you can see the fuel pump fuse actually has three fuses, because some of them are for the fuel injectors as well, so you always have to check everything. And looking at the diagram here, 68 is the main fuse, it's that little 15 amp fuse right here. So we'll pull this one out. Okay, the fuse is not burnt. Okay, you can see it's not burnt. If it's burnt, you're going to see a hole in it, in the metal diode. So it's not there. Always check the big fuses. Now, usually on most of the cars you have a mega fuse. This is the big fuse that pretty much controls everything. Okay, if that fuse is not working, your car will not start as well. Sometimes it might crank, sometimes it might not even crank at all. So I'll show you how to test this one without removing it, because you don't need to disassemble it. Okay, so we'll be using the voltmeter here. We'll test continuity of circuit right here. And we're going to see, okay, if we have any current here now. Not current, if we have communication now. If you go on one post on one side and another one, it should go to zero. Okay, because it's continuous circuit, so it's not burned anywhere. If it's burned, you're not going to, nothing will happen. Pretty much it will stay at one like that. Which means that this fuse is fine as well. Now, we know that in our case, okay, the fuel pump works. We don't know if we're getting ignition, spark. Okay, this is another thing. How you can check that, you can pull a spark plug and check this one, not too complicated. But what we are going to do, okay, it's something that I wouldn't recommend because it's dangerous and it's actually could be harmful on your car if you don't do it the correct way. To test if everything else is fine, we are going to remove the hose here. Okay, this is the intake hose. And we'll just put a few drops of gas and turn the engine on. But that thing can backfire and catch your car on fire, so you have to be extremely careful. You have fire extinguisher on the side and you can severely damage your car. But I'll show you how we do it and see if the car will fire, so we know what to look for more specific now. Okay, like this car here, this is a 3.5 V6 engine, so you have, since it's a V6, 6 ignition coils. All 6 cannot go bad at the same time, so if you don't get spark, it's most likely a fuse related or relay related. So always check the relays as well. So we're going to just add a little bit of gas here in a bottle, very little, and we're going to put in the intake hose and see if it's going to fire up. Okay, that's it, that's good, just a few drops. Now, in order to do that, we'll have to disconnect the intake boot, okay, right here, and in some cases you might need a screwdriver, in others you might need special tools, okay, like sometimes they use the Torx there, but usually it's just a clamp that you need to get loose. Okay, pull the hose out. Okay, perfect. And I'm going to go inside the car. Okay, let me show you now what we're going to do here. One person will just drop a few drops, not much. Okay, that's it, right there. And I'll go ahead and see if it starts now. Okay, so you can see that this car started, which means that we have a fuel related problem. Even though, okay, the pump works fine, okay, even though the pump works fine, we are getting sparks obviously because the car fire, the car seal does not start. So either it's a weak pump, and you can test that with a pressure regulator on the fuel line. Okay, you can see this is the fuel line. Or it's a bad fuel filter. So let's go ahead and see that now. Okay guys, so we ended up replacing the fuel filter. It was plugged up fuel filter. Now, let me go inside and I'm going to show you how that thing fires. Okay, right up now with absolutely no problems. So bad fuel filter caused that, guys. It was so bad, it was so plugged up, they never replaced it, the car. Okay, we're low on fuel, we need to add some. The car has only, it has 137,000 miles, I believe. I need to close the door to check. And it was an original filter from what it looks like, so that definitely solved our problem. So, if your car doesn't start, check for spark, check for fuel, alarm could deactivate it as well. Hopefully guys, the video will be helpful to some of you. Please hit that subscribe button for more videos and see you guys next time.